So in the last class, which is on Friday, we have just started what is meant by PPC and what are the different types of production systems we are going to be having in PPC. So the continuation for the last class. So in the last class, we learn about the three types of production systems. One is a job production, batch production, and a mass production. So we are also learn about the what are the characteristics of each and every type of the production system. So now comes about the process planning. So process planning is also called as manufacturing planning, process planning, material processing, process engineering, and machine building. So it is also known as, these are the different names for the process planning. So by the process, we can understand that it is nothing like a procedure. What is a procedure you are going to get followed to start your thing? So which machining process and parameters are to be used to convert a piece part from its initial form to a final form predetermined from an engineering drawing. So to start to get a final product, from where we are going to get starting, so what are the facilities we are going to be utilizing, and how it is to be get built. So this total thing is known as a process plan. Next, so the process planning, the flow chart of the process planning you can see here is, one is, the first one is the product design, process planning, operation programming, verification, scheduling, execution, and process machine knowledge and the schedule knowledge. So these are the different points which comes under the process planning. So the first question we have to know is, how can we make it? So how? So if some idea was there in your brain, okay, how it is to be get put on a paper? How it is to be get put on a paper? So what, which is the form you are going to be using? So whether it is existing or it is a new idea. So how can we make it? The first thing. So what are the different resources we want? So how it is to be get complete? How the product can be if it is completed? So these are the questions we are going to be getting. So next, how much does it cost? Yes, okay, you got a certain idea, but that idea is up to our mark, up to our investment, or it is a whoa, it is more and more. So how much investment you want to put in regarding that product? So third, how long it will get take to complete it? Yes, because it is a long run product or a short run product. So how much time it going to be taken to receive a customer? So if the product is to be get made within a certain time, within a short period of time, it can be just reach the customer and you can get a good profit. But the how much time you have to be, whether it is a long run or it is a short run. So that is to be get checked on. Next, how reliable will it be? So what is the quality? What is the quantity? How reliable? What is the serviceability? What is the purity of the product? What is the purity of the product? What is the durability of a product? What are the different characteristics of a product? Next, how can we recycle it? So how can we recycle it means, if you are going to be getting a product, if it is a dull product, if it is having a failure product, how it can be get recycled? How it can be get recycled? Can the parts can be used again and again? So or else the total product is to be get vanished. So how it is to be get recycled? So these are the different questions which we get stuck on into the brain, that when you are going to be starting a certain type of idea. So the flow chart, it really explains that the first one is, what is the product design? So when you got a certain type of an idea in your brain, so what is the first thing you will do is, okay, it is to be get implemented in the form of a diagram, the form of a diagram. So whether it is a 2D diagram or a 3D diagram, it is to be get implemented on a paper in the form of a diagram part. Next, if it is to be get in the form of a diagram, what are the different types of dimensions? What is where the tolerances are to be get given? Where the different types of GD and geometrical dimensions are to be get given or to it? So what are the different types of surface finishes or as any other thing? Or how it is to be? So full-fledged, the dimensions are to be get given for a certain product. So how it is to get designed? Okay, you had designed, you had done the diagram on a certain paper, but what is a 3D view? What is a 3D view? So you are going to be using a certain software to design the product, right? So okay, that you have got a certain part of the 3D view, everything was right. But nowadays, the technology is increasing more and more. Before you are putting an investment towards a product, we are not directly manufacturing a certain product, certain prototype. Okay, You are not directly manufacturing a certain prototype. You are just analysis. You are doing the analyzing of a certain product, which you've got an idea. And if you will get a good result, good conclusion, then only you will going to get start the product in a manufacturing part. Okay. So this total generation, which you are going to be using a certain type of software to do the product, it is nothing but a product design. It is nothing but a product design. So whether it can be an analysis part, whether it can be a 3D part or a 2D part. So whatever the thing you are going to use by using some software or any other thing, it comes under the product design, how it is to be get designed, what is the different output you are going to be getting, what is the input you are going to be giving. Okay, so that is the first one. The second, the process planning. So the process planning is, if your product, whatever you got an idea, it is up to the mark. Okay, you have got approximately the precision of 98%. There is not an accurate. I'm getting the precision of a 97%. So what you are going to be doing, you're just starting the product. So in what manner it is to get started product? So what is the different resources are there in your company? How it is to get started? From where it is to get started? Okay, it is not an exam to draw, to study the before a 1 day. Before a 1 day, it is not an exam. It is a product which you want to be get manufactured, and you are going to be get nearer to the customer, get nearer to the customer in a market. So in that manner, you must be aware of everything. You must be aware of everything. So what is the correct process planning you want? So process planning, it explains about the first one is process, machine, and a knowledge. Yes, the process planning is what is a process. So what is the process to complete that one by one, step by step? The second one is what is the type of machine is to be used? Whether the machine was there in your company, or else you have to be go to another place and you have to be do the machining part. Okay, so next, the third one is knowledge. So knowledge is totally the first thing in total production planning. Okay. Because if you are going to be getting any failures or any other thing, you must be in a position to accept the failure. You must be in a position to know at that point we can be get this one. Okay, so these are the different main three parts which comes under the process planning. So as you know, what are the three M's? Men, material, and machine. Three M's in an industry. Men, material, and machine. So whatever three M's, the same three M's comes under the process planning also. Okay, now. Next, the operation programming. So process planning, you have planned successfully. See, when you want to go for a tour, some another place from south to north. So you won't have a tour continuously. You will be having some stuck off. Yes or not? You'll be having some shortcut routes, and you are going to be having some shelters at different places, because you can't travel continuously from one place to another place, from south to north. Right? So you are going to be scheduling, you are going to be doing some process, you are planning in a certain way where you have to take a shelter at a certain point. So when you are going to be going for a north tour, in between the places, what you are going to be visit. So that in that manner, you are going to preparing. The same way here also, what is the correct process is to get prepared to manufacture a product. Okay. Next, operation programming. Operation programming is how it is implemented. You had implemented. You had written a process, but after implementation, so how it is implemented, that is nothing but an operation program. So if in an operation programming, if you are not getting a correct output, you will go again to the top. You will go again to the top to the product design. So in the product design, whether you had made any mistake or whether you had leave any topic there, leave any idea there, so you will go again to the product design. Okay, next, after operation programming, verification. So verification comes under the quality. The quality verification comes under the quality. So like what, how the pieces is, of the pieces, whether it is as per our dimensions, as per our tolerances, how the piece was there. Next, how in the verification part, if you are going to be getting a more failure parts, so where you have to go, you have to go again to the process. So in the process planning, what you have to check? The process, machine, and the knowledge. So in the verification, if you're not getting the points as per the rule, so you again follow the same process. Next, after verification, scheduling. Scheduling explains that how it is to be get scheduled towards the market. To reach the market, how it is to be get scheduled. So if the company is in a rural area, So one place to another place, how it is to be get scheduled? If the product is of a glassware, how it is to be get packed and how it is to be get carried over from one place to another place? Okay, so that is nothing but a scheduling. So scheduling comes under the scheduling and a knowledge also. Next, execution. So the scheduling was over. So you have to get executed towards the market. So these are the things which comes under the process planning. Next, what is the steps in a process planning? The first one is analysis of a product print. So the steps explains that whatever the points which we had just listened from the process planning, that all comes under the steps in a process plan. The first one, analysis of a product print and a specification. The second one, improvement of a specification. Third, make or buy decision. Make or buy decision. The fourth, selection of a basic manufacturing process. Fifth, determine the sequence of the operations. Sixth, combine the operations. Seven, prepare the list of the raw materials. Eight, selection of the machine tools or equipment. Ninth, inspection. 10, requirements of the tools, gauges, labels, etc. 11, time standards. The 12, cost production. And 13 is to prepare the operation sheet and a route sheet. Okay, so the first one is, what is the analysis of your product? So by using some softwares or any other thing, we have to do some analysis related to the product. By changing some dimensions over it or any specifications over it, we have to do some analysis over it. So next, what is the improvement of the specifications? So when you are going to be taking some 10% of the any of the material, so it is not up to the mark. So we have to be reduce the percentage of them, that material, or is any of the thing. So how it is the improvement of the specification? So if you are putting a more speed, so that speed is not withstanding that product. So how to decrease the speed? So how much speed we have to be take? So what is the improvement of the specification? Next, make or buy decisions. So see, when the small pieces are there, which are to be used in your product. So you have to take a decision that whether the small pieces have to buy it from some another company or the small pieces have to be get manufactured in our company. So that is the first criteria which we have to be getting. Because when you are going to manufacturing the small pieces, how much time it is to be get taken? So by when the small pieces are manufacturing, is the time is consuming more and more, or else it can be a very easy process? That is the decision we have to take, because already you had made some investment. So you know some other companies are manufacturing small pieces which are very essential to our product. So you have to be in a position to buy the small pieces which are very, very requirement was there, so that we can reduce the time then. We can reduce the time for uneven product, so that we can have a good concentration over your product. Okay, now. So make or buy decision. You have to make or buy decision regarding a pieces which is irrelevant to your part. Next, the selection of the basic manufacturing process. What is the selection? So you are having a different five machines in your unit. So what which machine is to be get selected regarding your product? So how it is to be? So what is the selection of your basic manufacturing process? Or else, if you are having different types of materials regarding your product, which is a good material is to be selected so that we can get a good efficiency. So what is a selection? Next, determine the sequence of operations. So what is a sequence of operation to complete your product? Okay, see students, you know the machine tools lab. So in a machine tools lab, see, I had given a diagram which is having a shaping, which is having a facing, turning, tapering, and a knurling. And a drilling also. Okay, now the first one is a facing, the step, the turning, and a knurling, and as well as a tapering and the drilling. So in this one, will you do the tapering first? No, we will do the facing first. Right, we won't do the tapering first. We will do the facing first, because if you had done the facing, it is a cylindrical part which can be hold in a check in a correct manner. But if you have to do the tapering first, we can't hold the workpiece in a correct manner. It can be having some fickle part. It can be have the shaking. It can be done. So we won't do the tapering operation in the first part. So we have, what is the sequence of operation is to be followed regarding your product. Okay. Next, What is the selection of machine tools of the equipment? So what is the selection of a machine tool? So which is the type of machine needs to be get used? Next, inspection. So what type of inspection needs to be used? Whether it is followed an NDT or else any destructive testing part. So in the day-to-day life, the most of the products are to be checked with the use of an NDT only, not by using a destructive part. Because NDT gives a good efficiency, quality part, so that the product cannot be get damaged. Right. Next, what is the requirements of a tools, gauges, and a labor? So when you are going to manufacture 1,000 pieces of your product, so you have to be think in a manner that how much labor is to be sufficient to a product. Whether to manufacture 1,000 pieces, 1,000 labors cannot be get required. Right. So what is the quantity of your product? What is the quantity? What is the quality of your product? So in one day, in one machine, on one machine, how many pieces can be get manufactured? How many pieces can be get manufactured? How much time is to be get taken? So as per this analysis, the labor is to be get selected. And a sum of 5 to 6 labors are to be kept in a buffer. 5 to 6 labors. Because if one person take a leave, the another person can be get adverse over the product. Okay. So similarly, what is the selection criteria regarding the selection of your labor? And what is the tool certificate used? What are different types of tools? What are the gauges? No gauge or a slip gauges, go gauges. So what are the gauges certificate used? What is the time standards? What is the time standards? What is the time of your company? How much time you are going to be taken to manufacture a certain product? So it depends on this one only. You have to be accept the tender from the customer. Okay. Next, what is the cost of production? So complete after completion of your production, what is the cost of the production? Next, the prepare an operation sheet and a route sheet. So prepare an operation sheet. Operation sheet explains the production sheet, which explains that what is the sequence of operations, what is the type of cutting fluids are to be used, what is the time of that operation. So at what time the piece is to be loaded on a certain machine, and if the piece is to be loaded on another machine, what is the time to be taken from this machine to that machine? So what is the type of operation sheet is to be get prepared, and what is the route sheet? Route sheet explains that what is the sequence of your process. That is nothing but a route sheet. Okay. So this is known as a steps in a process plan. Okay. Next, the factors affecting the process plan section. So the first one, what are the factors that affect the process plan section? The first one is the shape. The second one is the tolerance. The third one is the surface finish. The fourth one is the size. Fifth, material type. Sixth, quantity. Seventh, value of the product. Eighth, urgency. And ninth is the manufacturing system expense. Okay. So these are the different factors which affect on a process plan selection. Okay. So with this, the process planning is to be get complete. So now we will come to the what is the stages of a production planning company? What are the different stages of your production planning company? What are the different stages? So this is known as the production PPC life cycle. This is known as a PPC life cycle. So different stages are, one is the pre-planning, the planning, and a control. So these are the three different stages in a PPC. One is a pre-planning, the second one is a planning, and the third one is a control. So comes under the pre-planning, the product design and development, the process design, sales forecasting, work center design, factory layout, technology adaptation, equipment selection, change in capacity, pre-planning production. So once again, I will do it. One is the product design and development, how it is to be get designed and how it is to be get developed. The second one is the process design. What is the process? The third, sales forecasting regarding the sales, how it is to be get estimated. Next, work center design. What is a work center? Next, factory layout. What is a factory layout? Next, what is the technology adaptation? Whether you are following the old part or a new. Next, equipment selection. Next is change in capacity. Next is pre-planning production, etc. So this total comes under the pre-planning. This total bar comes under the pre-planning. Next comes under the planning. One is the materials, methods, machines, men, knowledge, and information. Materials, methods, machines, men, knowledge, and information. This total six comes under the planning. Next, under control, scheduling, estimating, routing, dispatching, inspection, expediting, and follow-up, and evaluating. Okay, so scheduling, estimating, routing, dispatching, inspection, expediting, and follow-up, and evaluating. So this all comes under control part. This all comes under the control. So this total diagram explains about the PPC life cycle. The total diagram explains about the PPC life cycle, starting from your product design to your evaluating. Starting from your product design to your evaluating. So after completion of a pre-planning, it move over to the planning. And after completion of a planning, it at the last stage of the planning, information. From the information, it is to get start over to the routing. So routing explains that what is the correct type of procedure. So from the routing, what is the estimating? What is estimation? Next, from the estimating, what is the scheduling? Scheduled. Next, dispatching. Dispatching from one place to another place. Next, inspection. Next, expediting and follow-up. Next is evaluating. So this all comes under the production planning and control. Okay. So see, this is the thing is, what is the relationship between production planning and the production control? So what is the relationship between that and this one? You are explained that it is a production, it is a PPC. So what is production planning and control? So see the inputs. So the first one is production system. Production system. So for the production system, what are the inputs given? Men, material, machines, energy, and information. Men, material, machines, energy, and information. So what is an output? So you are going to be getting the goods and the services. You are getting a goods and a service. So from the production system, you are having the first one is production control. First one is production control. Next, after that, it is going to the feedback and a modify plan. After that, it is going to feedback and a modify. Because, we'll be having a board meeting. In the board meeting, we are going to be implementing some type of scheduling, some type of scheduling, some type of routing procedure to implement a product, to implement a product. So in a board meeting, so all the people from in an organization, they have to be give an acceptance to start that procedure. They have to give an acceptance to start that procedure. So what is the feedback of each and every person regarding that routing procedure? So that is a feedback or a modified plan. If any of the person was want to be changed the plan, so it can be get modified. It can be get modified. So after giving a production plan, we have to be having good board meeting. In a board meeting, we will get accept the plan so that it can be get implemented by the manufacturing unit. Okay, so feedback or a modified plan. After that, it is going to a production planning, and again it is going to the comparison, and again it is a production control. Comparison and production control. So this is one way. And next, it is from the output, you can go for a comparison from the output. So if you got an output of a certain product, you will check the output with the initial product, yes or not? Because you can't blindly give a product to a market. You will check the output with the existing product also. So what is the existing part? We have a good comparison there. If a more deviation was there with an existing part, again you go to the production plan. Where you have to get changed there. Where you have to get changed. Next, after that, the company objectives. From the company objectives, how it is to be get planned. Okay, so this is the relationship between the production planning and production control. Okay. So we will have each and every description there. The first one is the stages of a production planning and control. The stages of production planning and control has three phases, namely planning phase, action phase, and a control phase. Planning phase, action phase, and a control phase. First, a planning phase. So phases of production planning control first comes under the planning phase. So planning is an exercise of an intelligent anticipation in order to establish how an objective can be achieved or a need fulfilled in circumstances which are invariably restrictive, So production planning determines what is the optimal schedule, what is the sequence of the operations, economic batch quantity, machine assignment, and dispatching priorities for the sequencing. So it comes under the optimal schedule. What is an optimal schedule? What is the sequence of operations? What is an EBQ, economic batch quantity? What is the machine assignment? What is the dispatching priorities for the sequence? It has a two categories of. One is a prior planning. The second one is an active planning. So the first one is a prior planning. So prior planning means a pre-production planning. It is nothing but a pre-plan, which you had seen the before flowchart. Pre-production plan. Next, this includes all the planning efforts which are taking place prior to the active planning. So before active, before it is to be get implemented, what is the things is to be handled? First, the modules of the pre-planning are, the first one is the product development and design, the second forecasting, and third is aggregate planning, and fourth is material requirement planning. So this all comes under the modules of a prior planning on follows. The first one is a product design and product development and design. It is the process of developing a new product with all the features, which are essential for effective use in the field and designing it accordingly. At the design stage, one has to take several aspects of the design, like design for selling, design for manufacturing, and design for usage. So design, what are the different several aspects comes under this? Design for selling, design for manufacturing, and design for usage. Next, forecasting. Forecasting is an estimate of a demand which will happen in future, since it is only an estimate based on a past demand. What is the past? Previously, what is the demand of a certain product? If the same product is getting into the market, whether the same demand will be there or else it can be a decrease, what is analysis of that product? So proper care must be taken while estimating it. Given the sales forecast, the factory capacity, the aggregate inventory levels, and the size of the workforce, and the manager must decide at which rate of production to operate the plant over an intermediate planning horizon. So that is nothing comes under the forecast. Next, aggregate plan. Aggregate planning aims to find out a product-wise planning over the intermediate planning horizon. Next, material requirement plan, MRP. It is nothing but a material requirement plan. It is a technique for determining the quantity and timing for the activation of a dependent items needed to satisfy the master production schedule. Next, active planning. So the modules of the active planning are process. So this total comes under the pre-planning. This 4 points comes under the pre-planning. Next, active planning. The modules of an active planning are process planning and routing, materials planning, tools planning, loading, and a schedule. Okay. So process planning, routing, material planning, tools planning, loading, and a schedule. So what is a process planning and routing? Process planning and routing, it is a complete determination of the specific technological process steps and their sequence to produce a product at the desired quality, quantity, and cost. It determines the method of manufacturing the product, selects the tools and equipment, analyzes how the manufacture of the product will fit into the facilities. Routing in particular prescribes the flow of work in the plant, and it is related to the consideration of the layout. Temporary locations of the raw materials and components and material handling systems. Okay, so the process planning and the routing. So process planning explains about what is the quality, what is the quantity, and the cost. So the routing explains that what is the layout, what is the temporary locations of the raw materials, what is the components, and what is the material handling systems. So this all comes under the process planning and improvement. Next, the second one is a material planning. Material planning. So which is a process which determines the requirements of the various raw materials or sub-assemblies by considering the trade-off between the various cost components like carrying cost, ordering cost, shortage cost, and so forth, and then etc. So it is a process which determines the requirements of a various raw materials or sub-assemblies by considering the trade-off between the cost components like carrying cost, what is an ordering cost, what is a shortage cost, and etc. So what is order cost? Okay, so that all. Next, the tools planning. The tools planning, it explains that the requirements of the various tools by taking process specification, surface finish, length of the job, overall depth of cut, etc. Next, material specifications, the type of material used, the hardness of the material, shape and size of the material, etc. And the equipment specifications, the speed range, and the depth of cut. Okay, so the first process of specification explains that what is the surface finish, what is the length of the job, what is the overall depth of cut. These are the main things which you will see. And material specification is what is the type of material used, what is the hardness of the material, what is the shape and size of the material. Okay, whether it is a nano part or a big part. So what is the type of the material, size of the material. And next, equipment specifications. Equipment specifications, what is the speed, what is the feed, what is the depth of cut. Okay, next, loading. So loading is a process of assigning jobs to several machines such that there is a load balance among the machines. So that no machine is to be get idle. So this is relatively complex tasks. Which can be managed with the help of an efficient heuristic procedures. Okay, so if all the machines are to be engaged, you have to be designed, you have to be planned in a certain manner so that any of the machine cannot be kept idle. Next, scheduling. It is a time phase of loading and determines when and in what sequence the work will be carried out. So this fixes the starting as well as the finishing time for each job. So this fixes the starting and the finishing part. So this comes under the second one is active planning. So we will see what is an action phase. So action phase has a major step of dispatching. So action phase, it comes under the planning part. So action phase is dispatching. So dispatching is the transition from planning phase to the action phase. In this phase, the worker is ordered to start the manufacturing the product. The tasks which are included in dispatching are job order, store issue order, tool order, time ticket, inspection order, move order, etc. Okay, so the dispatching task explains as what is a job order, what is a store issue order, what is a tool order, what is a time ticket, what is an inspection order, what is a move order. So these are things which comes under the dispatching. So what is the job order? So what is meant by that one? The job order. The job order number is the key item which is to be mentioned in all other reports or orders. Next, the store issue order. It gives the instructions to stores to issue materials for manufacturing the product as per the product specifications. So see, when you are going to be doing any of the operation in your lab, in a metrology lab, so what you will do depends on your product, depends on your experiment. You are going to be take the tools. And you are going to be utilizing that. The same thing, when you want to manufacture a certain product, what is the tools is to be get required for it. So in that manner, we have to be take that. So gives the instruction to stores to issue materials for manufacturing the product as per the product specifications. So as per the tooling requirements for manufacturing the product, the tool order instruct the tool room to issue the necessary tools. Next, time ticket. So time ticket is nothing but a card which is designed to note down the actual time taken at various process. So it is nothing but at what time you had started your process. So this information is used for deciding the cost for future jobs. of similar nature and also for performing variance analysis, which helps to exercise control. So this is the main use of this one is, if you want to manufacture the same product after 5 years, you can have a certain idea. So that so and so time, when you use this type of material on this type of machine, it was taken 2 hours of time. It was taken 1 day of time. So that is nothing but one of the difference. So this is nothing but a time taken. Next, a job order. So job order is an official authorization to the shop floor to start the manufacturing the product. Generally, the process sequence will contain some testing and inspection. So these are to be instructed to inspection in the form of an inspection order for timely testing and inspection, so that the amount of the rework is minimized. So the manufacture of a product involves moving a raw material sub-assembly to the main line. So this is done by a well-designed material handling system. So this can be done when a good conveyor system is to be used. So proper instruction is given to the material handling facilities for major movements of materials and sub-assemblies in the form of a mover. So movements which involves the less distance and fewer loads are measured at the shop floor level based on the request from operators. So this all comes under the action phase. So the action phase purely explains about the dispatching unit. Next, control phase. So control phase, we are having two modules. One is a progress reporting and another is a corrective action. So what is a progress report? So in a progress reporting, the data regarding what is happening with the job is collected. Okay, so whatever the data is to be required for the job, it is collected. Also, it helps to make the comparison with the present level of performance. So it will have a good comparison for the past and the present. So the various data pertaining to materials rejection, process variations, equipment failures, operator efficiency, operator absenteeism, tool life, etc. are collected. So why the material, why the so-and-so material was failed in so-and-so time? Why that is to be having a failure? Why that material is not used up to the mark? So there is some reason. So what are the that reasons? So the reasons comes under like the pertaining of the material rejections, process variations, equipment failures, operator efficiency, life and etc. That is to be collected and analyzed for the purpose of a progress report. So these data are used for performing the variance analysis, which would help us to identify the critical areas that deserve immediate attention for corrective actions. So this comes under the progress report. Next, corrective action. So the task under the corrective action primarily makes the provisions for an unexpected event. Some examples of corrective actions are creating schedule flexibility, schedule modifications, capacity modifications, make or buy decisions, expediting the work, pre-planning, and so on. Okay, so the tasks under corrective actions primarily make the provisions for an unexpected event. Unexpected, if anything was done, so what is action to be taken? So some examples of the corrective actions are creating schedule flexibility. Schedule flexibility must be there. Schedule modifications must be there. Capacity modifications, make or buy decisions, expediting the work, pre-planning, and so on. So due to unforeseen reasons such as the machine breakdown, labor absenteeism, too much rejection due to poor material quality, etc., it may not be possible to realize the schedule. Yeah. So due to the unforeseen reasons, like a machine breakdown, when you are going to be doing on a certain machine, it can be a half breakdown. So labor absenteeism and too much rejection due to the poor quality, etc. So it cannot be have possible to realize the schedule as per the plan. So under such condition, it is better to reschedule the whole product mix so that we can get a clear idea, right? It is better to cancel that schedule and we can make a good schedule so that we can have a correct idea where it was a certain mistake was there. So picture of the situation to progress further. So under such situation,
it is to be re-examined for selecting the appropriate course of action.
So when you are going to preparing a correct new schedule, we won't do the same mistake what we had done in the previous part. Right. So some corrective actions was to be taken.
Next, expediting means taking action if the progress reporting indicates deviations from the original set targets. So reporting explains that one only. The progress reporting indicates the deviations from the original part. So pre-planning of the whole FIs become essential in case the expediting fails to bring the deviated plan to its right path. Okay, so what is the pre-planning? It is the whole FI becomes essential in case of the expediting fails. Okay, so that's why the pre-planning is to be done. Okay, so with this, today's class is completed, students.